Hello dear students, good morning. In today's fluid mechanics class, in last classes we saw some application of Bernoulli's equations like in venturi meter and orifice meter. We derived the equation of flow through venturi meter and orifice meter using Bernoulli's equation. So in this class we will see few numericals on the basis of these two devices, venturi meter and orifice meter. The numericals and orifice meter will also be solved, as we will solve the numericals of venturi meter. So let us see that how to approach to solve the numericals related with venturi meter flow. Let us see a very interesting example. An oil of specific gravity 0.8 is flowing through a venturi meter having inlet diameter 20 cm. The inlet diameter means that will be pipe diameter, and throat diameter 10 cm, full stop. The oil mercury differential manometer shows a reading of 25 cm, means this is the value of X, the difference of two column of mercury, U2 manometer, full stop. Calculate the discharge of oil through the horizontal venturi meter. Here the problem is clear, that the horizontal venturi meter means venturi meter is horizontal, full stop. Take CD is equal to 0.98, that is coefficient of discharge. So very first we draw the arrangement of the venturi meter, and this is the venturi meter and this is the pipe through which fluid is flowing. And this is the U2 manometer. The reading of U2 manometer, that is 25 cm. It is given in the numerical. I have marked on the figure. And the diameter of pipe D1 is 20 cm. That is 0.2 meter. And it is the diameter of throat D2 is equal to 10 cm. That is 0.1 meter. And rho is the density of flowing fluid through the pipe. That is rho is equal to 0.8 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. It is given here, specific gravity 0.8. So by multiplying 10 to the power 3, we get the density of the oil flowing through the venturi meter. And I have indicated here rho m, that is manometer liquid, that is mercury, because it is given that oil mercury differential manometer. So this word indicates that there is mercury in the manometer. Rho m is equal to 13.6 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. And CD is equal to 0.98, given it is coefficient of discharge of venturi meter. So we have to find out the discharge through this venturi meter. This is the first step. All the data we have marked on the figure, whatever possible, and other data we wrote side below of the figure. So step number two, we know that discharge through venturi meter is given by Q is equal to CD A1 A2 under root 2 GH divided by under root A1 square minus A2 square. Here all the terms are clear. A1 is the cross section area of the pipe through which fluid is flowing, and A2 is the cross section area of this throat of ventilometer, and this G is the acceleration due to gravity, and this H is the differential head, or because it is horizontal ventilometer, so H is the pressure head here, difference of pressure head here, and divided by under root A1 square minus A2 square. So we know very well that H can be found out by using this equation. H is equal to X into rho M minus rho by rho, where X is the reading of difference of two column of ventilometer, and rho M is the density of manometer liquid, that is mercury, and rho is the density of fluid flowing through this pipe. So by writing all these things here, we get H is equal to 4 meter. This should be our first step following this, because in this equation we have to find out this. So this is the first step. We have found out this H, and now A1 is equal to cross section area of pipe, that is pi by 4 D1 square, and pi by 4 into 0.2 square, that we are getting 0.031416 meter square. Next step, cross section area of throat, that is A2 is equal to pi by 4 D2 square is equal to pi by 4 into 0.1, throat diameter 0.1 meter. So we are getting, after calculation, 0.007854 meter square. Next step, we will put all these values, H, A1, A2, in this discharge formula. Q is equal to 0.98 coefficient of discharge, and A1, this is the value of A1, this is the value of A2, and under root 2G, this is the H we have found out here, and under root A1 square minus A2. After solving this equation, we get Q is equal to 70465, that will come in meter cube per second, but the very suitable unit for this volume is liter. So we will convert this meter cube in liter by dividing 1000. As we know that if we have to convert meter cube into liter, we will have to divide by 1000, and if we want to convert centimeter cube into liter, then we will have to multiply by the 1000. So here meter cube per second, we want to convert it into liter per second, so we will have to divide this equation by 1000, and finally we will get Q is equal to 70.465 liter per second. So in this way, by writing all the data given in very systematic way, by drawing figure, we will label the data, and rest of the data we wrote side of the figure, and step by step, and this I have indicated this steps 2, step 3, step 4. In this way we can solve very easily this problem. So let us see one more problem. So next numerical is a horizontal ventilometer with inlet dia 20 cm and throat dia 10 cm is used to measure the flow of oil, specific gravity 0.8, full stop. The discharge of oil through ventilometer is 60 liter per second, full stop. Find the reading of oil mercury differential manometer. Take CD is equal to 0.98. Here discharge is given, and we have to find out this value of X, reading of oil mercury differential manometer. So I have drawn this ventilometer. This is horizontal. I drawn this ventilometer, and label all the data, whatever possible, on itself in the venturimeter. This is the D1, that is the diameter of pipe, 20 cm, and this is the D2, diameter of this throat of venturimeter, that is 10 cm, and this is a rho m, mercurimeter density, that is manometer fluid, 13.6 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. And this is the CD is equal to 0.98 coefficient of discharge of venturimeter. And this is the rho, that is the density of flowing fluid through this pipe, that is given an oil having density, having a specific gravity 0.8, so density will be 0.8 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. And discharge is given, Q, value of Q is given, Q is 60 liter per second. So I will prefer here to convert it into centimeter cube per second. So 60 liter per second will be converted into centimeter cube per second by multiplying by 1000. That is 60 into 10 to the power 3 centimeter cube per second. And it will be converted into meter cube per second by divided by 1000. So here I have also written this, but we will use this centimeter cube per second, because if we will use in SI unit, so we will get the value of diameter, this cross section area, in very very small in decimal. So I will prefer to use this centimeter cube per second, the unit of length. So we have to find x is equal to what? This is the manometer reading. So as we know that the discharge through venturimeter is given as Q is equal to CD A1 A2 under root 2GH divided by under root A1 square minus A2 square. Suppose this is the equation 1. A1 is the cross section area of the pipe, that is pi by 4 into diameter square, and it is coming out 314.16 centimeter square. And our next step is A2 is equal to cross section area of the throat, that is pi by 4 into throat dia square, 10 square is equal to, it is coming out 78.54 centimeter square. Now let us put all the values in equation 1. Q discharge is given, I am taking it centimeter per second, centimeter cube per second, 16 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to 0.98 coefficient of discharge. This is the A1, this is the A2, under root 2 into G will be 981 centimeter per square, 981 centimeter per second square into H divided by A1 square minus A2 square. By solving above equation for the value of H, we get H is equal to 289.98 centimeter. So this H is giving this difference of pressure head over at the inlet of the venturimeter and at the throat of the venturimeter, that is the P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g. But we have to find out the value of x. As we know that the relation of h and x is like this, h is equal to rho m minus rho by rho into x. So here h is, we have found out already, 289.98, and this is equal to, this is the rho m, mercurimeter density minus oil density by oil density. By doing calculation for this, we get x is equal to rho h by rho m minus rho, because we have to find out x. So we will separate out x from this equation. So we will get x is equal to rho h by rho m minus rho is equal to, this is the rho is equal to 0.8 into 10 to the power 3 into h is equal to 289.98, and this is the difference of these two, will 13.6 minus 0.8 into 10 to the power 3. After solving this, we are getting x is equal to 18.12 centimeter. So in this way we can find out any unknown thing if we are having sufficient data to find out that. But that we can do if we are having a systematic approach for doing that. Otherwise, there may be confusion to solve this. So in this way we have found out the value of x, the manometer readings. Let us see one more problem for a vertical manometer. Let us go through one more numericals, but here it is for vertical venturimeter. Here in this case venturimeter is not horizontal, so numericals is like that. A 30 centimeter into 15 centimeter venturimeter is provided in a vertical pipe carrying oil of specific gravity 0.9, comma, the flow being upwards. Here it is cleared in the problem that flow being upwards means venturimeter is vertical. The difference in elevation of throat and entrance section of the venturimeter is 30 centimeter. It means the vertical height of throat from the entrance of venturimeter is 30 centimeter. Full stop. The differential U to mercury manometer shows a gauge deflection of 25 centimeter. Full stop. It is the manometer reading, that is the 25 centimeter value of x. Full stop. Calculate number one, discharge of oil. Number two, the pressure difference between entrance and throat of the venturimeter. Take CD is equal to 0.98, that is the coefficient of discharge of venturimeter. Let us draw a systematic line diagram of this venturimeter. This is the vertical venturimeter and this is the U-tube manometer. The reading of U-tube manometer is showing 25 centimeter as given in the numerical, and this throat die is 15 centimeter, and this pipe die is 30 centimeter. It is given starting of the problem, and the height difference of these two section in vertical direction where the manometer is fitted is 30 centimeter, means Z2 minus Z1 is 30 centimeter. Here we have to find out the discharge through pipe, number one. Number two, difference of pressure. I have shown here difference of pressure here. We can separate out from here the difference of pressure. So let us see how to solve the problem. First, very first we find out the cross section area of the pipe. Cross section area of the pipe will be pi by 4 d1 square. Is equal to d1 is given 30 centimeter, so it will come out 706.85 centimeter square. Next step, cross section area of the throat, that is pi by 4 d2 square is equal to pi by 4 into d2 is given as 15 centimeter. By solving this we get 176.7 centimeter square. Now differential head, the value of this will be h, as we know from the derivation that we assume this h, in derivation z1 was equal to z2, so that was coming p1 by rho g minus p2 by rho g, but here z1 and z2 also here because it is vertical ventilometer, the difference of z1 and z2 is 30 cm, so this differential head will be equal to, that is the h. So we know that the value of this differential head will be equal to h, and h is solved as x into rho m minus rho by rho. So by writing all the given data here, we are getting the value of h is equal to 352.77 cm. Here x is 25 cm, rho m is 13.6 × 10⁻³, rho is equal to 0.9 × 10�³. I have taken out common this 10�³ here and divided by this rho, 0.9 × 10�³. By solving this, we get 352.77 cm, the value of h. This is the differential head. In case of horizontal ventilometer, it is itself difference of pressure head. The differential head will be itself difference of pressure head, because this term will be zero in horizontal ventilometer, horizontal orifice meter. Let us say this is equation 1. Next step number 5, let us find out discharge through ventilometer. That is Q is equal to CD A1 A2 under root 2 GH divided by under root A1 square minus A2 square. Here all the data is available. CD is equal to 0.98, A1 we have found out 706.85, into A2 is equal to 176.7, under root 2 into g is equal to 981 cm/s² into h is equal to 352.77, that we found out in equation 1, divided by under root, this is the a1 square minus this is the a2 square. After solving this equation, we get q is equal to 148790.5 cm² per second. And let us convert it into liter per second by dividing by 1000. Now finally we get discharge is equal to 148.79 liter per second. Now let us find out the other unknown things which is asked in the question, that is the pressure difference at entrance and throat, that is P1 minus P2. Again let us come on the equation 1. Equation 1 is P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g plus Z1 minus Z2 is equal to 352.77. That is the value of h. And I am writing this P1 minus P2 by rho g plus, from the refer the figure, Z2 minus Z1 is 30 cm, because Z2 is above, that is the throat dial, and Z1 is below, that is the entrance dial. So Z1 minus Z2 will be negative, that is the minus 30 is equal to here 352.77. And from here separate out P1 minus P2 by rho g, that is equal to 382.77 cm. Let us convert it into meter, it will come 3.8277 meter. And P1 minus P2 is equal to 3.82 into rho g, and here rho is the density of oil, that is 900 kg/m³. G is the acceleration due to gravity, that is the 9.81 m/s². After multiplying all these terms, we get the value in newton per meter square. But we want to convert into Newton per centimeter square. So I am writing here 10 to the power 4 here in denominator, 10 to the power 4, we will get this Newton per meter square into Newton per centimeter square. So finally we get this pressure difference, that is P1 minus P2 is equal to 3.3795 Newton per centimeter square. So in this way we can solve the problem by following a systematic approach. In next class we will see one more application of this Bernoulli's equation, that is the pitot tube. As I have explained earlier, that is used to measure the velocity of flow at a particular point. So in this class your assignment will be these three numericals plus two more numericals we will solve your own. You will not solve the examples from the book. You will solve two numericals from unsolved, that is from exercise. You can use the any book, but I have referred that you use R.K. Bansal, so that is a good book. So thank you.